Welcome to all. Myself Kelata, contract lecturer in botany. I am working at Dr. B.R.R. Government College at Cherla. Today we discuss about the one of the major plant tissue system, that is the vascular tissue system. By this end of this lesson, we all know what are the different vascular elements and their structural details and types of vascular bundles and different functions of vascular tissue system in the plants. These are the major objectives of this lesson. Before going to our lesson, we all need to know what is a tissue, what is a tissue system. We all know what is a cell. Cell is a structural and functional unit of a living organism. A group of cells, they form a tissue. A group of tissues which form a unit, which acts as a single unit and perform a single or a multiple functions in the plants, that is known as a tissue system. Here, the scientist Sachs classified the tissue systems of plants into three types. They are epidermal tissue system, ground tissue system, vascular tissue system. These three tissue systems, which are derived from the apical meristem. Three different regions of the apical meristems, they form the different tissue systems in the plants. Majorly, epidermal tissue system is derived from the or differentiated from the protoderm of the apical meristem, and as well as ground tissue system is differentiated or developed from the ground meristem region. And lastly, the procambium divides and forms the vascular tissue system. The vascular tissue system, which is derived from the procambium region of the apical meristem. These are the different regions which develop the different plant tissue systems in the plants. Let us start our lesson, that is the vascular tissue system. Vascular tissue system, it is a major type of a plant tissue system. It constitutes the two vascular elements. They are the xylem and the phloem. In the steel region, xylem and phloem, they combine and form the vascular tissue system. Each vascular bundle contains the xylem and phloem. In between the xylem and phloem, these vascular elements, xylem and phloem, are separated, may be or may not be separated by the cambium. Based on this character, two different types of vascular bundles are identified in the plants. One is the open type of vascular bundles, second one is the closed type of vascular bundles. Let us see what is the open type of vascular bundles. In which vascular bundles, the xylem and phloem are separated by the cambium in between the xylem and phloem is said to be open type of vascular bundles. Majorly, this type of vascular bundles are found in the stems of the dicots and the gymnosperms. Then next, closed type of vascular bundles. In which vascular bundles, the xylem and phloem, they lack the cambium in between the vascular tissues, are said to be closed type of vascular bundles. Majorly, this type of closed vascular bundles are found in the roots of the plants and also monocot stems also, they show closed type of vascular bundles. Generally, the cambium which is present in the vascular bundles is said to be intrafascicular cambium, majorly helps in the secondary growth. Based on the arrangement of vascular bundles in the stellar region, two types of steels are found or identified in the plants. They are eustele, second one is the atactosteel. These two types of steels are identified based on the arrangement of vascular bundles in the stellar region. First one is the eustele. Let us see what is a eustele. In which steel, the vascular bundles are arranged in a ring around the pith or medulla, are said to be eustele. Majorly, this type of eustachelic type of steel is found in the angiosperm plant roots and also stems of the dicots. They show eustachelic type of steel. Here, the picture clearly visible explains vascular bundles are arranged in a ring, a complete ring around the medulla or pith region. This is the eustachelic type of steel. The next second type of steel is the attractor steel, in which steel the vascular bundles are scattered or they are arranged in the scattered in the ground meristem. Ground tissue is known as the attractor steel. Majorly, this type of attractor steel is found in the stems of the monopods. Here is then a special case. In some plants, the vascular bundles are arranged in the medulla also. Means the vascular bundles are found in the medulla also. That kind of vascular bundles are known as the medullary vascular bundles. Mostly found in the Mirabilis, Bayerhavia, Bougainvillea, Acrantha stems, they show medullary vascular bundles. Means the vascular bundles are majorly found in the medullary region also. The next, cortical vascular bundles. Means here the vascular bundles are found in the cortex region, are known as the cortical vascular bundles. This type of cortical vascular bundles are found in the casuarina stem and in nictantha stem. We found cortical vascular bundles. Then next, already we know what are the vascular elements. Xylem and phloem are the different vascular elements. Let us see xylem. Xylem, it is in one type of vascular tissue. It majorly helps in the conduction of or transportation of water and minerals in the plants. It transports the water and minerals to various parts of the plants. It is a water conducting tissue. Based on the formation or based on their origin, two different types of xylems are found in the xylem. Then one is the primary xylem, second one is the secondary xylem. Means here the xylem which is derived or formed from the procambium is said to be primary xylem, whereas in the secondary xylem it is formed from the vesicular cambium. In primary xylem again two types of xylems are formed. One is the protoxylem, second one is the metaxylem. The first formed of the primary xylem is known as the protoxylem. The later formed primary xylem is known as the metaxylem. Based on the position of the protoxylem and metaxylem in the plants, three different types of xylem conditions are found. One is the exarch condition, second one is the mesarch condition, third one is the endarch condition. Let us see what is the exarch condition. Protoxylem faces towards the outer side and the metaxylem faces towards the inner side of the plants. That kind of condition is known as the exarch condition. Majorly, this type of condition is found in the roots. Then mesarch condition. In mesarch condition, here the protoxylem faces towards the center and metaxylem present on either side of the protoxylem is said to be mesarch condition. This type of mesarch condition majorly found in the ferns and also as well as cycas leaf. They show mesarch condition. Then next, lastly, endarch condition. In this condition, the protoxylem present at the inner side and the metaxylem present towards the outer side. This condition is known as the endarch condition. This endarch condition mostly found in the stems. Then the different xylem elements are majorly found in the protoxylem are tracheids, vessels and xylem parenchyma. They lack the or the fibers. Then next, whereas in metaxylem, tracheids, vessels, fibers and phloem, xylem parenchyma, these four elements are found in the metaxylem. The vessels has the large big pores and their secondary walls, they contains the pits on their secondary walls, and these pittings, they show different thickenings on their secondary wall. the thickenings are reticulate or pitted type of thickenings which are found in the metaxylem. Then next, let us see what is the primary phloem. Primary phloem is also developed from the procambium. It majorly helps in the conduction or transport of the food materials. In angiosperms, different types of phloem elements are found in the sieve elements, companion cells, phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers are present in the primary phloem. Whereas in pteridophytes and gymnosperms, they lack the companion cells. Instead of that companion cells, albuminous cells are found in the gymnosperms and pteridophytes. Generally, these albuminous cells, they store the food materials, means they store the starch. Generally, based on the position of the phloem in the vascular bundles, two different types of phloems are found, external phloem and inner phloem. External phloem means the phloem which is present external to the xylem is said to be external phloem. Then next, in some species, especially Cucurbitaceae, Solanaceae, Compositae, Apocynaceae, Asclepiadaceae plant members, they show phloem towards the inner side and as well as external to the xylem also. This kind of situation, this kind of condition is known as intraphloem. Then let us see what is a cambium. Cambium, it has the meristematic character, means it divides and forms the new tissues. It is majorly found in the in between the, it separates the xylem and phloem in the vascular bundles. Based on this character, open type and vascular bundles are found. Means the vascular bundles which contains the cambium are known as the open type of vascular bundles. Majorly it is found in the dicots and the gymnosperm stems. It majorly helps in the production of secondary tissues and by the production of secondary tissues, it majorly helps in the secondary growth. The cells of the cambium are thin and the cytoplasm contains many vacuoles. Two types of cells which are found in the cambium, they are fusiform initials, ray initials. Let us see what are the fusiform initials. Fusiform initials, generally they contain the long and slender cells. These cells divide and produce the secondary tissues like secondary xylem and secondary phloem in the vascular bundles. Whereas in ray initials, they contain these small isodiametric cells, and these cells divide and produce the secondary medullary rays in the stem region or plant organs. Let us see different types, what are the types of vascular bundles. Based on the arrangement of xylem and phloem in the vascular bundles, four types of vascular bundles are identified. They are collateral vascular bundles, bicollateral vascular bundles, concentric vascular bundles, radial vascular bundles. These are the four types of vascular bundles. They are identified based on the arrangement of xylem and phloem in the vascular bundles. Let us see what are the collateral vascular bundles. In this type of vascular bundles, xylem and phloem are arranged in a same radial axis. They are present in the same radius and these are present side by side. Xylem and phloem are present side by side. These xylem and phloem, they are separated, may or may not be contains the cambium in between the xylem and phloem. Based on this character, two types of conditions are observed, that is the open type and the closed type. Open type of collateral vascular bundles means the cambium which is present in between the xylem and phloem are known as the open type of vascular bundles. They are mostly found in the dicot stems. Whereas in closed type of vascular bundles, cambium is absent in between the xylem and phloem, majorly found in the monocot stems. These are the collateral vascular bundles. The next, second type of vascular bundles is the bicollateral vascular bundles. In this type of vascular bundles, xylem and phloem are present in the same radius, but the xylem is present in the center and either sides of the xylem, phloem is present on either sides of the xylem. This type of vascular bundles are known as the bicollateral vascular bundles. When we see from outer side to inner side, four different types of tissues are formed. They are outer phloem, outer cambium, xylem, inner cambium, inner phloem. These are the different tissue regions which are found in these bicollateral vascular bundles. Mostly this type of bicollateral vascular bundles are found in the cucurbitaceae members and the solanaceae members. Then let us see what are the concentric vascular bundles. Here in this type of vascular bundles, xylem, one type of vascular tissue is surrounded by the another vascular tissue. Here xylem is present in the center and which is covered by the phloem, or vice versa, the phloem is present in the middle and which is surrounded by the xylem. Based on the presence of this position of the xylem or phloem in the center, two different types of concentric vascular bundles are found. They are amphicribral vascular bundles and amphivasal vascular bundles. Let us see what are the amphicribral vascular bundles. In these vascular bundles, the xylem is present in the center and which is covered by the phloem. That kind of vascular bundles are known as the amphicribral vascular bundles. Majorly found in the Selaginella and Fern species, they contain this type of amphicribral vascular bundles. Let us see what are the amphivasal vascular bundles. In which vascular bundles the phloem is present in the center, which is covered by the xylem elements, are known as the amphivasal type of vascular bundles. Especially this type of amphivasal vascular bundles are found in the Dracaena stem. Both these amphicribral and amphivasal vascular bundles are closed type. Here cambium is absent. Then last type of vascular bundle is the radial vascular bundles. In this type of vascular bundles, the xylem and phloem are present on different radius. Here the xylem and phloem is separated by the parenchyma tissue. These are the vascular bundles, or the radial vascular bundles, mostly found in the roots region. These are the different types of vascular bundles which are found in the plants. Now let us discuss what are the different functions of vascular tissue system in the plants. Majorly xylem and phloem, these two tissues are known as the conducting tissues. Here they helps in the conduction of water and food materials. Xylem majorly helps in the conduction or transportation of water and minerals in the plants, and phloem majorly found in the transportation of the food materials, and also secondary xylem, it gives the strength to the plants. Based on these are the different functions of the vascular tissue system. Thank you.